Hey YouTube, it's Elvis Ammo here. Hey, today I got a follow up on the zinc bullets that we made. You guys, you know, obviously was very curious, you know, about this, and I'm glad that you were, because this is something that definitely perks my curiosity about this zinc that we have left over in our wheel weights. And that's kind of what started this whole thing, one of you guys actually in the past, and I'd been meaning to do a video for the longest time, you know, had asked me about trying to make some zinc bullets, and you know, I did the best I can, you know, to reply to the comment without saying they're crazy. But at the same time, I'm like, you know, it's not so crazy. And I said that in the last video, as I was molding those bullets, as I was laboring over the pot of zinc and trying to make these zinc bullets, and they just wasn't cooperating very well. Well, I knew that I needed to do a follow-up video, because I did actually make some bullets to shoot. And I'm not going to lie, you know, I decided I'm going to just load up a couple of them, try to use, you know, some common sense and logic with as much data as I can gather to find a starting point, because there's no data for this sort of thing, to find a starting point, since that's kind of what we're famous for anyway, shooting powder-coated bullets, you know, coming up with data, you know, with as much support as we can to come up with a safe starting point and do some ladder testing and find a safe load and you know, increase or decrease from there. But you know, that's what I've done with this these zinc bullets. Now, these are the zinc bullets that I made. I actually made one dozen bullets that I deemed was, you know, presentable and shootable and was well formed by all measures, really. I mean, just perfectly formed almost. And I'll tell you, you know, what I done to them, very little I done to them, you know, to get them ready to shoot. Now this is the zinc bullet right here. Try to give you a close up. You see those driving bands on this bullet? That's where I run it through the sizer. You can see they appear darker on the camera. They appear darker. So these bullets from that arsenal mold that I used was well suited, I think, this bullet design, you know, for actually coming up with some data, you know, with some bullets that don't have a lot of pressure. Now this right here, I'll show you the base. This is the base of the bullet. Now the bases of the bullet, you seen in my other video where I was doing my best to make some zinc bullets, that the sprues, I had to really whack those sprues to cut them, you know, because I wasn't fast enough and I was probably trying to make too many at one time. I always do that, don't I? So what I ended up doing, there was on some of the bullets, there was a little bit of sharpness here. And I literally just took a piece of sandpaper, put it on a towel so the towel will serve as a soft and base. And I just took the base of the bullet and just barely sanded it down on top of the sandpaper. I mean, just, it only took a few strokes and it knocked it right down on these zinc bullets, no problem. I was thinking it was going to be more to it than that, but they were good enough. Well, here's the nose too. Let me show you the nose of the bullet. You can see they're very well done. I mean, you know, you can just about find an imperfection on it. And I would have thought, you know, that, man, these things are going to be bad, not going to be formed right, going to have wrinkles all in them, none of that. It just, the ones that filled the mold, of course, you know, the ones that I was able to get the zinc in the mold in time before it tried to harden on me, they just formed perfect, really, pretty much, you know. Now on some of them, obviously, I didn't get the mold filled fast enough and the bases were rounded and all that, so it wasn't going to work. But these, I actually had one dozen that looked this good. And I done some quick testing on some of them, and I was going to bring you along from the very beginning. I thought, well, let me just shoot a couple. Maybe I can get it somewhere in the zone and be able to kind of show off a little bit at the same time with 12 bullets. Didn't happen. But what I did accomplish is I found a starting point, and with all the fuzzy math that I used, along with experience, logic, and a little good luck, I ended up I found this was the kind of the end point for me in the data book. This was the out of modern reloading. These bullets ended up being, let's see, I have 4 bullets left that we're going to shoot today. 33.5 grains, 33.4. .1, .2. Alright, so I got .1, .2, .4, and .5. That's pretty good. And they were all that consistent. As a matter of fact, some of them were exact the same of the 12. But this was the ending data that I kind of settled for to use after finding a reduced load to shoot. This is a 35 grain, and it calls for accurate 57.44. And when I found this, I was ecstatic, because I'm like, that's perfect, because what I'm looking for is a reduced load. Now I could find other loads, and the reason I'm looking for a reduced load is because the size of this bullet, the slowest twist rate that I have is a 1 in 8, and the 1 in 8 is, you know, for generally heavier bullets. You guys know that. So the starting data here was 19.2 to 21.1. I actually, my first shot with this was 18 grains, and the data and the chronograph clocked it at 2759 feet per second at 18 grains with this 33.5 grain bullet, zinc bullet. So I mean, when you pick one of these bullets up, it is noticeably lighter. If you were to pick this bullet up, you would know automatically it's just not a lead bullet. And the next thing that I done was I didn't lube it, and I didn't powder coat it. I just shot it, just like this. And I didn't clean my rifle yet. This was yesterday. So I thought, you know, when we get done shooting all this, I'll just kind of give you a quick view inside and just see if there's anything to look at. So being as I have a 1 in 8 twist, I thought, you know, these bullets at 33.5 grains are going to be, you know, a longer bullet for the weight. Longer for the weight. All right. So that's helpful. Longer bullets require more stability, you know, technically speaking, you know, coming from a redneck scientist. They're longer, so that's helpful. Because, you know, all I have is a 1 in 8. So, the next thing is that the other thing that I could do to help myself with shooting these 33 and a half grain bullets out of a 1-8 would be to slow the bullet down as much as possible, and have a functioning rifle and slow it down as much as possible without making the bullet unstable for its weight. Like bullets like this want to travel fast. The length of it for the weight is helpful. So I thought if I can find a reduced load, a safe reduced load, because sometimes, you know, there's only so much reduced you can shoot that's still safe. You know, don't forget, you can't just shoot any old powder you want at any weight of powder that you want to use. It's not necessarily safe to shoot reduced loads. I've said that before. But in this case, today we're going to shoot, we're going to load these up and we're going to shoot them at 20.3 grains. Now, I haven't tested that on the Crony. I did fire one shot at 20.3 just to see if it was safe, because I was trying to dial it in and I just wasn't able to dial in the accuracy with that many shots using one powder. I definitely wasn't going to switch powders with just 12 bullets and confuse myself even more. So this is kind of a fun day to where we can shoot these zinc bullets, see if they're shootable, see if they mess up your barrel, see if they mess up your gas system. We're gonna see what they look like on paper, and we're gonna see. I'm gonna try to get these over the Crony. You know, sometimes the sun ain't just right. You're not gonna get a good reading. I'm gonna do my best to get a chronograph reading on these. I suspect that they're gonna be traveling at maybe 3,200 feet per second, something like that. That's my suspicion. We'll see. So, but the data says, you know, that 19 grains is 3169, 21 grains is 3602. Just based on what I've seen, I'm just guessing on that, around 3,200 feet per second. That's my guess. It could be faster than that. Could be 34. We'll see. But this thing, you know, I will say this, you know, as far as accuracy, I haven't found that load, you know, I haven't found an accuracy load for it yet with this bullet or that rifle or anything like that. But what did happen is every hole that went into the paper was perfect holes, you know, surprisingly exciting. So we might just have a new method of making bullets, especially making bullets for rifle calibers that are a little more finicky, like the 223. Now, I have some surprises coming. I've ordered some stuff, some molds, I ordered another lead pot. I believe in it enough to have invested some cash in the deal, because it's pretty exciting to me. And guess what? I have plenty of zinc. And I'm so sorry I ever give up a piece of zinc, but I've given up to the scrap guy just like you guys have. But we may found use for this thing, and if the government has their way of banning lead, at least we have something else we can fall back on. Banning lead on public lands, hunting, wildlife management, that kind of thing. We still got bullets we can make. To please them crazy rascals over there, if we have to, or we can just remain free and do what we want, right? So anyway, let's load some of these up. I just wanted to give you a quick story, and I wanted to also tell you, you know, that we have some cool stuff coming up. I'm gonna make some 30 calibers and ultimately, we have a 56 grain bullet, if it was lead, turning out to be 33 and a half grains. So, you know, one of the things I'd like to do is come up with an oversized mold that maybe we could shoot a heavy caliber lead 223 round, and it can double as a run of the mill 50-ish grain 223 bullet in the zinc. So I mean, that's kind of where I'm coming from here and going. So just kind of throwing that out there. I may do the same thing sort of with maybe a 30 caliber bullet, and we can kind of move on from there. But you know, obviously, you know, we want to fill this finicky zone. Let's go ahead and load this up, and I just got it's all the bullets I have left. I have 4 bullets, and they all weigh, you just seen me weigh them, and they all look practically exactly the same. Those are the 4 bullets that I have left. I was like, you know what, I could have done another video later. I don't know how much later it would be though. All right, and I know that you guys are interested in this. You know, people ask me all the time, you know, where we at on the zinc bullet and that kind of thing. And I don't want, this was 3 weeks ago that I done this video. And, you know, things happen slow sometimes. You know, it takes a lot of time, and there's other things to do besides just this. So I wanted to just jump right back on this. I know I'm in the middle of doing my 357 38. I still have 38s to do and some other stuff with that. But I wanted to go ahead and jump in here and get this done and show you some results. And then we'll move on from there. And now the next video that I do with this may actually have something real to show you, you know, something really exciting. And especially once I develop a process that's practical to use to make these bullets. So let's go ahead and load these up. I'm going to be using 20.3 grains of 5744. This happens to be a good powder to use for reduced loads to begin with. And I'm just using some, this is just some already been fired Lake City brass. There we go. We're going to start right there. And we're going to use 20.3 grains. All right. Went over a little bit. That looks like it right there. Give it a second. So that's 20.3 grains right there. And we'll put that right in. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and load this one right here. And then I'll finish loading the other 3. And I'll see you out on the range. Let's see. I think I have this thing set 2.170, something like that. Seemed like a good spot for it for seating. Yep. 2.171.5. All right. So that's where I'm going to seat that bullet right there. And I'm going to go ahead and crimp it. Now there is no powder coat, no lube. Just a zinc bullet. And I noticed with this powder, on the lighter crimping, I was getting a lot of powder left in my barrel. So I went ahead and crimped it a little bit heavier, hopefully burn up a little bit more of that powder. That was my solution for it. and it did much better. Still a little bit left over. So we're going to put, this is going to be a just over medium crimp, I call it. Because that's what seemed to look the best on here. And I mean, I go as far as look through the magnifying glass and everything. And you know, you can see where it completely took away the, you know, the any sharp edges here at all. I'll let you see the crimp. Maybe. There's the crimp. It's kind of hard to focus sometimes, I'll tell you. But look at that. I mean, isn't that pretty? You know, that is, you know, just lovely, huh? Got a zinc bullet. That's exciting to me. I mean, that's what I love doing this show for. You know, you guys, you know, always like, hey, man, what about? I love it when you guys, like, egg me on, because that's the kind of thing, you know, we learn so much from this kind of thing right here. You know, come up with just a new solution sometimes to, you know, problems as they arise, like the lead-free zones and all this other stuff, you know, or for a lot of us that have all these wheel weights and all this zinc we're throwing away. So anyway, I'm gonna load these other three and I'll bring you back and we'll take some shots. I'm gonna do my best to get the chronograph reading on it, and maybe we'll shoot three over the chrony and into the target. That's hard for me to do, by the way, you know, trying to hit a target and going over the chronograph without shooting my chronograph or missing the target. Anyway, I know you guys think I'm nuts for that, but it's true. Now I want to save at least one bullet and just shoot it into the ballistic gel and just see if we can recover one. That'd be awesome. You guys might say, don't worry about shooting it over the chronograph. Let's shoot them all into the ballistic gel. Anyway, we'll see what comes up. I'm gonna finish these last three, and I'll see you on the range. Let's see what we get. Nice zinc bullets. We'll just see if we get a reading. We may stop and try for some ballistic gel. Got an error. That's not good. I might have to move some things around. But it hit right where I wanted it. Alright, let's see what we can do this time. I had to move the chrony around a little bit. We'll shoot one more. 3,079. All right, we'll save this next one. Try to get it in the ballistic gel if we can. All right, that's what the, I went ahead and took this bullet out. It had loaded over my feed ramp. I just thought I'd show it to you. There's absolutely no scraping of any kind on it. So I just thought I'd show you that real quick. Now, to shoot this ballistic gel, I put a catalog book and a piece of wood. Maybe we'll catch this thing and take a peek at it. I don't know. Let's see if I can find this thing. All right. So, anyway, I didn't think I was ever going to find this bullet. I found it, though. I'll show you. All right. Dummy me, you know. when you only have one bullet to shoot left, you know, you under pressure, I guess, you know. I mean, you know. Just trying to hit the ballistic gel, right? Well, I shot it low, right there. And you can see the trail cruising up through the ballistic gel. And there was cardboard under it. You can see the mess of cardboard. And then it started splitting out of the ballistic gel to right here. So maybe nearly 3/4 of the ballistic gel it went through. And then it went through the cardboard into the piece of wood. But that's the trail it made, just a nice thin line, you know, right through. Started splitting, went into the cardboard, and into the wood. Now you've seen those big blocks of wood that I have. It went into maybe 2.5 inches. It's kind of scraped across that first block of wood and went right into the grain, the cut end of the second block of wood, about that far, and it done some splitting and all, and I was able to just dig it out with my knife. And here's the bullet. It don't even look like the same bullet anymore. It don't have any of the micro grooves. I didn't look at it good enough to even see if you can even see a sign of micro grooves in it anymore. I mean, it smoothed that sucker right down. I guess I can. I can, with a magnifying glass, I can just barely see the signs of the micro grooves. This is a bullet right here. I could probably shoot it, But it has just a little bit of warpage on one side, but I'll show you the comparison. This is what the bullet looked like before. And after. I'll show you this best I can. It has a, see, it has a little cutout right here. I guess where it went into the wood, right on one side. Whenever I saw it, that side was facing up. I'm like, oh, it's broken half. Well, it's not. It's not even close to broken half. Now, I'm interested to see what happened when you shoot steel with one of these. I suspect we'll find out. You might be able to make it out on camera. Little bit of what's left of what the micro grooves. Now, I believe that all happened in the gel and the wood, and not in the barrel. Only because, you know, if you look at the bullet in the calipers here, you know, up to the light, this is what makes this a good bullet. I don't know if y'all, a good bullet for the for low pressure. Let's just see if you see how where the contact is of the bullet would be in the chamber. Not a lot of contact. Not a lot of contact with the bullet. So I certainly don't think that it smooths it out down the bore, but it's possible. We'll find out more about these bullets. Maybe not even these bullets, maybe some more bullets, some different style bullets. I have some different ideas. But this is, that was the bullet. We did find it. I was very pleased. I mean, oh my God, you know, only four bullets to shoot. And I've played around with those other ones trying to make something happen for us. And, okay, now, okay, here's the base of the bullet. We'll see that. Nothing special that I can see happen to the base. It looks normal. And there's the nose of the bullet. And again, I don't see anything special. I really don't see any kind of mushrooming. I can sort of make out the sort of kind of the joint, maybe, you know, where the mold comes together. But, you know, that's it right there. It's pretty exciting stuff. You know, just shot some zinc bullets, guys. Let me show you the target. This was unexpected because in my rounds that I was shooting, I told you they were putting nice perfect round holes. Well, this was my first shot right here, and I was aiming for this spot right here, by the way, but you can see that bullet went in there cockeyed, and there's no doubt about that. So that was a bit of a surprise because I've not seen that yet in my testing. Now, by the time I got to this 20.3 grains, you know, my bore was warm at that point, I guess. You know, so maybe that's cold bore first shot. And then I had to move the chrony because I got an error, and I knew that the sun wasn't quite right. I had to make a little adjustment to make this happen as best I could. And I can't remember if it was this one or this one. I think this was my second shot. And I was aiming for that tape right there. So that was pretty good. And you see the hole. Nice round hole. And that was my third shot, I guess. And it looked pretty good. Not perfect. Not as perfect as this one. So... anyway, we wasn't going for accuracy. We were just wanting to hit paper. You know, that's really what I was going for. Hit paper, catch one in the gel, and take a look at it. You know, something exciting like that. But this is a hopeful round. I mean, this is doable. Now, let's take a look at let's take a look at this. Let me go ahead and pull all that out. Alright, I'm not going to get too deep into this. I'm just going to take a look up here at the light myself. I'll tell you what I see for one thing. Nothing. I didn't clean it. So that was 12 zinc rounds that went through this total. And I can tell you that... Let's just see if you guys can take a quick look. I'm not going to get too much into this and waste your time with all this. Alright, let's take a look at this side. A better opportunity over here. Gonna turn some of that light down a little bit. Maybe you can see that a little bit. I hope so. Anyway, you can take my word for it. There's just absolutely nothing there. You know, the other thing there would be is in the bolt. Matter of fact, I mean, this thing is kind of dry. I mean, it's kind of dry. But, I mean, of course, there's never anything here, really. There's just a little bit of, like I said, it's kind of dry. I'm going to look down this gas tube and just see if... No, I didn't expect anything. And here we go. Here's the fouling on the bolt. A lot of people like to see that. You know, it looks like just regular old fouling to me. There's nothing that stands out at all. I'm taking a look. I'm just going to wipe it in my hand right here and just see if that tells me anything. See what's left over after a finger wipe. All right, that's a finger wipe. Now you can kind of see it just shining. There's just nothing on it. I mean, that's my finger. So, yeah, everything looks good. I'm going to look down inside the gas tube. Yeah, just nothing there. Matter of fact, I didn't, just now, when I looked down the barrel, I didn't even see any powder with this charge 20.3. It really burned that powder up, where when I started at 18, I had a lot of powder left, and that's an extruded powder, kind of looks like 4198 IMR. That stuff does. It's a rough extruded powder, so you know they tend to do that when it don't burn up. I mean, you can see every piece of it because it stands out. It's so large. Anyway, YouTube, I just wanted to. There you go. You know. We just shot some zinc bullets. We got more to come. I'm gonna make some different style bullets, and we're gonna shoot them and just see if this is. I mean, is this a viable option? I mean, darn thing's looking good. I'll be honest with you. I had low hopes in the very beginning, and as this has progressed in my testing and checking some stuff out and kind of doing the fuzzy math, it's looking good. Let's see. YouTube. I appreciate you guys. Thank you for all your comments and questions. You guys are awesome. I'll see you in the next video.